Honorable Rasamanikam.
Mangana Katanagatamani. I would like to ask the Honorable Prime Minister to inform this House. Number one, the total number of political prisoners in the country and the number of camps they are detained in. Number two, why expedited measures have not been taken yet with regard to their release. Number three, the number of lands occupied by the security forces in each district across the country. And number four, the number of private lands and the lands of the government officers controlled by the security forces. If not, why?
අරු කතා නැගතුමනි ශ්‍රී ලංකා දණ්ඩ නීති චන්ද්‍රා යටතේ හෝ මෙරට පවත්නා වෙනත් කිසියම් නීතියක් යටතේ දඬුවම් ලබා දී ඇති සිරකරුවන් හෝ සැකකරුවන් අතරින් දේශපාලන චෝදනා මත සිරගත කොට ඇති හෝ රඳවා ඇති කිසිවෙකු මේ වෙන විට ශ්‍රී ලංකා බන්ධනාගාර තුල නොමැති බවට මේ කරු සභාවට කියන්න කැමැති. කරු කතා නැගතුමනි දිවයින පුරා දිස්ත්‍රික් කණුව ආරක්ෂක හමුදාව විසින් රඳවාගෙන තිබෙන ඉඩම් සම්බන්ධව පිළිතුරු දීම ජාතික ආරක්ෂාව ඉල්ලුම් බලපාන බැවින් මේ සඳහා පිළිතුරු ලබා දීමට නොහැකි බව ආරක්ෂක අමාත්‍යාංශ විසින් දන්වා තිබෙන බව ගරු සභාවට දන්වන.
මගේ පළවෙනි අතුරු ප්‍රශ්නේ තමයි my first question is honorable prime minister there are people who have been in custody since the time even before I was born. You know, some of them have died in prison in the last couple of years. One of your main election promises was that the release of these political prisoners will be done. This was done in the canvassing campaigns that was done in the north and the east. And even Honorable Namal Rajapaksha, when he was released from remand prison, had mentioned that these political prisoners need to be released. At the same time, I need to place it on record that JVP, during the JVP insurrection, people who were arrested were given general amnesty. And also, the Honorable Johnston Fernando mentioned the other day that Pulyan was a political prisoner. He was not a political prisoner. He was under arrest for the murder, as charged for murder under suspicion of Joseph Parag Singham. And at the same time, people have been given pardoned. Sergeant Sunil Ratnayake, who was charged with murder and sentenced, and he was pardoned. So why aren't these some of these people, these cases haven't still even been filed, right? They're still being held without they're still being detained without charges being filed. As you may have been aware, we had a campaign called Pothuvil to Palikandi from the 3rd to the 7th last week, and one of the primary requests that were put forward by the people who joined this protest was the release of these political prisoners. And in Kilnochi, there were some people who were relatives of people who had surrendered to the army during the last days of the war in the Matruwal Palam. And along with them, there were parents of people who were arrested during November 27th last year for posting photos on Facebook. So their genuine concern was that the people who were arrested back in the day and the people who surrendered to the army in 2009, all of them were taken by the armed forces. Likewise, now in November 27th, there were nearly 40 odd youngsters who were arrested for posting photos on Facebook and so on and so forth. And now they are still, no charges have been filed against them as well. So naturally, there is a concern that in a few years, that these people, these boys could also be missing because these people were arrested. So my question is, why is there two laws? I mean, why is there two laws, one law for different people, and why aren't these cases being expedited? So we can, I mean, sir, you know, as the Prime Minister, I know that you have the capacity to do it and you are genuinely concerned about these people. I would like to see that as the Prime Minister of this country, that you take some action against this because you are the only one who can do this. And we have 100% faith in you, and this was the election promise that was put forward. And it wasn't just TNA that's asking for this. The march, the Pothuvil to Palikandi march that happened, nearly 100,000 people joined this. And one of the main slogans, one of the main requests was the political prisoners. Likewise, even with the Easter attacks, there are people who have been detained for almost 2 years with no files, cases being filed against them. So I would like to, my first question is, sir, what is happening to them? Are they going to be released or are they going, because now election has been won, you got 2/3, presidential election was won, these things were used for politics. Are you all going to hold these people in prison just for political mileage, or is there a plan? That's my first question, sir.
Permission of Honorable Prime Minister, I would like to answer that question of the Honorable Member of the Parliament. First, immediately after the 2009 defeat of the LTT, there were about 12,843 LTT suspects who surrendered to the government. Government rehabilitated them and put them back to the society as a policy. All of them were reintegrated to the society, they were given skill training, and they are now more or less living in harmony with the rest of the people. Including 600 child soldiers. So that's the policy of the government throughout that been. As the Honorable Prime Minister very clearly explained, there are no political prisoners in this country detained anywhere. But there are few people who have been detained or their cases are pending, charged under prevention of terrorism mode. I would like to bring it to the attention of the Honorable Speaker and also the Honorable Member of the Parliament. I submitted that list consequent to a question raised by Honorable Suren Raghavan few days ago. I will resubmit that and give you a copy of that. All those people who have been either detained or their cases are pending for your information. And furthermore, Honorable Member, on the direction of the His Excellency the President and the Honorable Prime Minister, about a couple of weeks ago, I myself and the Minister in charge of public security had a discussion with the Honorable Attorney General and also His Lordship the Chief Justice of your concern. One is how to expedite those cases. We also believe those cases has to be quickly disposed of. You can't eternally keep them on remand. And also to file cases against those there are charges. And therefore, if someone says that we have deliberately kept them behind, it's a very limited number. The charges against them are very, very high and grievous. And also, Honorable Attorney General have been asked to look into those individually. So we will keep you update on the progress to the House and to you, Honorable Member.
It's very ironic that the Justice Ministry is responding to these questions when the Honorable Justice Minister's own community's issues cannot be resolved by himself and the Prime Minister with the Janasa issue. Please, not your time. So my also one of the grievous issues, the grievous concerns, you said that it was very serious concerns that they are detained against. But some of these some of them have been detained most recently for posting photos on Facebook and posting a poem on Facebook. I'm very shocked that that's a grievous crime. So I would like to move on to my second question. You know, while we were going through the protest from Pothuvil to Poligandi, while we were going through Mulathivu, Mana, Kilnochi, it was very evident that there were so many military camps. The number of military camps, the Prime Minister has said that he is unable to disclose the information due to security concerns. I understand that. But however, there were so many military camps throughout the North and the East. So I would say that, you know, that this government's primary slogan was, establishing national security. So if this government is able to establish national security, I wonder why there is such a need for so many camps. But at the same time, why aren't we worried about setting up some camps in Colombo and Hambantota, there, because like I mentioned in my parliamentary speeches, Tamils and Muslims in this country are not the threat to this government in the near future. You know, we are giving out plots of land to different countries in the south and in Colombo. So why don't we set up some army camps and, you know, security forces camps around those ports and districts as well? Because like I mentioned earlier, they are the threat for this government in the future. I'm sorry if I'm offending anyone by saying this, but these are all concerns, not just by mine. Right, these are not questions that I'm asking for myself, I don't have any family or friends who are political prisoners who are affected by this. Because even in Batticloa district, there are in Kalavanchikudi, even the divisional secretary's office, even the divisional secretariat's office, and also like the irrigation department's office, even those. I will ask my question. This house wastes a lot of time on random stuff. There are a lot of people wasting time on random things. These are questions that are genuine questions that are of the people, right? You mind your own business, right? This is not, you're not the Prime Minister. So my question is, please, right? Your people who want to be the Prime Minister of this country can talk. I am asking this question from the Prime Minister. Mr. Surendragon is not a Prime Minister. You are not a Prime Minister. Let me finish my question.
Order, please.
I will. Don't waste my time. Don't waste the time of this house. This house wastes a lot of time on unnecessary issues every day. Right? I have observed that there are so many unnecessary things.
Yeah.
I get this opportunity once a year maybe. We only get the opportunity to ask the Honorable Prime Minister a question once a year maybe, because the opposition, there's only one. Just mind your business, Surendragon. You have been appointed the nationalist for this, right? You're barking because you got the nationalist. Just mind your own business. I'm not here on the nationalist. I have been elected by public, right? You're just trying to build your political career. I have already been elected to parliament by votes. Now, unlike you, I didn't come on the national list. I was elected. So let me finish my question. So my question is, sir.
Please.
Statement, just tell us, what is your question?
Sir, I can't finish my question, sir. Yeah, thank you. Listen to the sir. So the question is, will these private lands and will these lands that are occupied by the security forces, the official, the government lands and the state buildings like irrigation department, DSS, even Kalavanchikudi, right? Will they ever be released or are we going to hold on to them just so that we show the South that there is some major national security threat in the North and this, which is not there? That's my question. You work enough for your nationalist men.
ගරු කථානායකතුමනි, අද වෙනකොට යුද්ධෙන් පසුව අද වෙනකොට 97%ක් ලෑන්ඩ් එක ප්‍රයිවේට් සහ ගවර්න්මන්ට් ලෑන්ඩ් එක දැනටමත් දීලා තියෙනවා. 97%ක් ලෑන්ඩ් දීලා තියෙනවා. ඉතින් එතකොට ඊට පස්සේ ජාතික ආරක්ෂාව වෙනුවෙන් තමයි ඉතුරු ඒවා තියාගෙන ඉන්නේ. ඉතින් ඒක නිසා ජාතික ආරක්ෂාව ඔබතුමාට ක්වෙස්චන් කරන්න බෑ. ඒක ඇවිල්ලා ආරක්ෂක අමාත්‍යාංශයේ මගින් බුද්ධි තොරතුරු මගින් අරන් තියෙන පණිවිඩ ඒ අනුව තමයි. නමුත් දැනට 96%ක්
Yes, Rasmanikam.
Sir, that you can't mention that it's not true. There are lands. Don't you just came into the house? You just walked in. You didn't listen to the entire question, right? So don't say that I'm lying. Okay, so sir, that's it. Thank you, sir. I just wanted to make my point that I wasn't lying. That he just walked in. He didn't even listen to the entire question, sir. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you.